Hello, everyone. It's that time again. It's Mayor Monday. I'm Mayor Acquanetta Warren, and I am honored to have Fontana's Coast Team here. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Mike Hall, and I'm with the Fontana Police Department.
My name is Fabiola Lassa. I'm with the Department of Behavioral Health, County San Bernardino.
And my name is B.J. Myers with the San Bernardino County Fire Department. And over here we have Scout, and she's part of our team.
Welcome. Welcome, Scout. He likes the floor, I think. But could you tell us a little bit about what COAST stands for and just why you're so important?
Thanks, Mayor, for having us, first of all. We are the Community Outreach and Support Team, and it's through your guidance and the City Council that we were formed to go out there and help people that are in mental health crisis. It doesn't matter whether they're housed or they're homeless. We want to address their mental health. And part of what we do is we're trying to break the stigma surrounding mental health and mental illness.
You know, I'm so glad you said it doesn't matter if they're housed or unhoused. You're helping families.
That's right.
What do you think about COAST? What's your role?
My role, I'm the social worker on the team. So my role is to assist in linking people to services and making sure that the community feels supported.
Outstanding.
Well, my role really is to support the two of these awesome people, and I'm Scout's handler. And Scout's role is she really opens a door for us. Whether you do or you don't like dogs, she allows us to open a dialogue that we can communicate with an individual so that they would be comfortable with talking to us so that we can give them the benefit or the services that they're needed.
You know, as I go countywide and regional, everyone is developing the COAST team. Yeah. Doesn't that make you feel good that you started all this?
Yeah, it's amazing.
And now everybody, everywhere I go, you know, we're getting a COAST team too. Tell me, how are things going?
Well, I think it's pretty amazing, and it's a testament to Chief Billy Green and Chief Birchfield and Officer Hall, who actually were the founders and the brainchild of this team. And it's been so successful, and the reason why it was successful is because we've been given the liberties to do our job and to do what we feel was needed to support the members of this community. And San Bernardino County Sheriff's has adopted it. San Bernardino PD has adopted it. Ontario PD has adopted it. So it's pretty awesome to see that the individual work that people have done, along with DBH, that it's just growing, and it's pretty awesome.
You know, one of the things that I know when you first got started, there were some challenges.
Sure.
But just talk about some of the challenges and then maybe some success stories that you've had.
Well, I think one of the challenges was, is that we weren't communicating with each other. We were all trying to accomplish the same goal, but I like to use the term siloed. We were all siloing what we were trying to do. So what we did was, with the help of DBH and with the fire department, we all came together in the same room and we said, oh my gosh, we're trying to accomplish the same thing. It was like
a team.
Yeah, it was like going to a high school dance and wanting to dance but not knowing how to dance together. But we all loved the same music. So when we got over that hurdle, we found that we work great together. It was a little challenging at first because we just didn't understand what we were saying, although we were trying to accomplish the same goal. Now, we barely even talk to each other when we're on calls because we already know. Like, I know what Fobby's thinking. I know what BJ's thinking. And they know what I'm thinking. And so we get compliments all the time that, wow, you guys never even said anything. Like, how did you know that they were going to do that?
You know, I think it's interesting when I go to conventions and meetings, people want to know, how did you put together Department of Behavioral Health, fire, and police, and in some cases, I understand you have a medic with you too, and a dog, a comfort dog. How did that all come about?
You know, it's funny. It sounds like it's the beginning of a joke, right? Mm-hmm. You have a social worker, a police officer, and a firefighter walk into a bar. I mean, it kind of sounds like that's what it is, but really that's what it was. It was coming together three people that are totally passionate about assisting people that are in a mental health crisis and wanting to help people. Regardless, we don't care how you got there. What we want to do is look forward. And Scout, although people won't talk to us sometimes about their problems because there's still the stigma, Scout doesn't judge. Scout will look at you, say, pet my belly, I don't care. I just want to help you get there. And that is such a huge, huge, I don't want to say tool, but I mean, she is amazing.
You know, one of the things that I really love about your team is the way that you show up. You know, before you have the fire truck, you have the police car, and then Kalia San Bernardino on somebody's vehicle coming up, and the neighbors were going like, what's going on in that house? You're providing dignity because you show up in your van. And then I've seen where you've actually walked people out.
Sure.
When you are in the process of assisting this team, what is your biggest role?
Probably the fact that they are not alone. We're here to listen to them. We're here to help them. And at the end of the day, that's the biggest goal. We want to make sure that they feel supported, that they are getting the assistance that they need. And then even after the crisis has passed, we follow up with them, let them know if they were able to, if they had any challenges connecting to any services, how can we assist? Do we need to maybe take them to the, maybe it's transportation issues. So we also want them to feel supported after the crisis has occurred.
Well, I've got to tell you, I'm bragging about the county services that they have and how you all follow up with people and provide assistance. What happens, though, when you have an incident in a neighborhood or on a street corner? How do you activate each other?
As far as, like, how do we respond to that,
right,
that call? Well, one of our main functions is to support patrol. I have access to what we call our CAD system. So I'm constantly monitoring calls. I can see what calls are pending. I can see what calls have come in. And so that's how we get activated for the most part. But to be honest with you, people will call and ask for Fabi. People will call and ask for BJ. I mean, he's a sports coach. He's a baseball coach. And he approaches especially our adolescents, our teenagers, from that viewpoint. And they respond to BJ incredibly. So we get calls that way, too. We get activated that way from family members. But Fabi, BJ, and I all do post-incident follow-up. So we're constantly, like Fabi said, we're constantly calling these same people over and over again because we know, just like your car, getting the oil changed and everything, if you maintain that, then you don't have major emergencies later, right? Well, people are the same way. You know, if you continue to just grow that relationship and rapport, then you don't have major emergencies as often.
You know what I'm impressed with? When I called you directly.
Yes.
Oh, I know her. I know him. Mm-hmm. I know where they are right now. Mm-hmm. Because sometimes when I'm here at the office, I'll see them around City Hall. I know they're about to have a crisis or they're in the middle of a crisis. It's just so comforting that we have a team we can call and you come and take care of it. How are you supporting our business community? Because we know that particularly Unhouse love hanging out in front of these businesses.
It's a good point, Mayor. It's a huge obstacle nationwide, as you know.
Right.
But what we do is we are very active with the Kiwanis Club, City of Commerce. We are constantly make ourselves available. At the end of this interview, we'll put up our QR code. So we make ourselves very accessible. And what we try to do is not only spend time with the people that are in crisis, maybe homeless, etc. We also go to the businesses and we say, you know, just so you know, that person's name is John. And because that's still a person, right? They don't see it as a person. They see it as an obstacle, as a barrier between their business and their customers. But we want to make sure that people realize, including our business owners, that that's still a human.
Right.
That person's name is John. So why don't next time you come up and ask John to move? And if he doesn't, then call us.
Right.
We'll come and make sure he understands. But probably, I bet you, if you addressed him, then you could solve that issue.
You know, and that's so needed because people are so afraid of everyone. And they're afraid to ask for help. You know, one of the things that we get a lot of questions about is if that loved one is not listening to the caretaker, who can we call? How should that be handled?
We could speak to the loved one, try to connect them to services. There's the Department of Behavioral Health also offers other programs that will refer people to. So they eventually will get connected to services. Yeah.
If I can add something there, Mayor, Fabi is a genius at finding services for people.
Yeah.
She's absolutely amazing. And one of the things that we do is we also educate the families. So you'd be surprised on how many family members who have a 25 or 40-year-old family member that are going through a crisis, and they have no idea how to approach them and how to talk to them. But we'll spend countless hours on educating the family as well, even giving them information on programs that they can go through and stuff like that. Another thing that's very rewarding about this Coast team, it's a different kind of service. I've been a fireman for a couple weeks now, and Mike's been a police officer for quite a long time, and Bobby's done her job for a long time. And we get to see the reward at the end of this, because normally what I would do is we'd put somebody in the back of the ambulance and then we'd go to the hospital. I would never know how that patient's day turned out. Now we get to follow up these individuals, and we get to coach them, and we get to find them housing, and we need to get to find them jobs and take them to the DMV and get them their IDs and take them to get prescriptions and stuff like that. So it's a different type of service that when we all started wasn't normal for us, but it has been very, very, very rewarding for us as well.
That is amazing. I tell you, I love when people tell me they see you at DMV with somebody. Why are they at DMV? Uh-huh. They're helping one of our neighbors, that's what I call them, get their life back on track. Where would you all like to see this program go from here?
Let you
in
know.
A special, yeah. Perfect world, how would that do?
Ms. Mayor, that's a great question, because we love to see the fact that it's expanding. And not only each city is taking responsibility for their own communities, which is so vitally important, we would love to see it being covered 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, like we do so many things in the community. You know, we offer protection to people through the police department 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Well, we all know that mental health does not take a break. It does not take weekends off, and it doesn't work 9 to 5. So, you know, there's a lot of great things that are coming up. I think with your support, the city council support, and our other government's endorsements, it's going to continue to grow. We know this program works, and it will continue. So in a perfect world, the stigma of mental illness will be gone, and people will go seek out mental health as much as they do physical health at the gym. So that's what we'd love to see in a perfect world.
Yes, I believe that too. I think that the stigma of mental health also needs to be addressed, and I would like the stigma to eventually decrease and eventually be gone, so families, individuals can receive the help that they need.
You want to add on that?
Yeah, sure do. I would also, I agree with Mike, I would like to add more teams here in the city of Fontana.
More ships. We're 24/7.
But mm-hmm. To expand beyond that, I would love to see this program flow throughout the entire country, because mental health is not something that's going to go away. And it's something that's been needed for a long, long time. And with... like I mentioned before, Chief Green, Chief Burtfield, and Mike, I believe that they found a solution to help combat that and help give the resources to people who need it. And with educating the public and educating people like yourself and people in charge and making decisions, I believe that this type of program could be offered throughout the entire country that would benefit millions of people.
Well, I have to tell you, this was controversial when it first started. You know, we're all aware after George Floyd's murder, people were defund the police, and that never entered the lips of any of our elected officials. That was off the table at the beginning. But it was refreshing to have you all come and say, we have an alternative, particularly to certain calls, and it's working. So I can't thank you all enough for joining me today. And Scout, that includes you, too.
She's very comfortable with you.
Yes, she's very comfortable. I remember when you first brought her to council, she came right around the dais and laid her head right on my thigh, and I went, this is going to be hard to say no to.
Yeah, she is very hard to say no to.
She is wonderful, and she's been honored in several places. This is an issue that affects everyone. Those of you that claim, I don't have any problems with mental health, we all do. But it depends on the level that we need resources. And Coast Team is out there working every day for this great community, making a difference. And more importantly, They're bringing the families back together, and that's important. So thank you for joining us. And one of the things we say here always, Fontana together moves Fontana forward. Thanks for joining us.